looking at the next interstate champion.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WCE Interstate Championship. Introducing the challenger, Johnny Pierce.
Boo.
And the champion, the resident rock star, Sean Jovi! Woo!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, let me kiss my BBC.
Yep,
I need to kiss my baby.
And we are back once again with our WCE Interstate Championship match as we see the returning executioner, Jonathan Pierce, challenging our resident rock star, Sean Jovi, for the Interstate Openweight Championship. And this event has a bittersweet meaning to Mr. Pierce here, because DJ Mikey here, I have to tell you that the last time we saw Jonathan Pierce, he was at the losing end at the first ring instruction and basically had to retire for a bit here.
That is correct. He is the very first Interstate Openweight Champion, and he did come back, and he said he was coming back to make things right, and he wants that title. And here we go. And
he's just kind of, you know, just baiting Jovi in there, playing some kind of
different. He's come out different, you know, playing mind games. Usually we don't see Jonathan Pierce come out like this. He used to come out strong and more aggressive, but this time he's playing a little mind games. And here we go, Jonathan.
Just right away, just camming away at Jovi with those big clubbing strikes. And he's gonna whip him. Oh, so what's he gonna go for? Big lariat into the corner.
And look how aggressive.
Another one.
Look how aggressive he is going. He is going 2.0 off the rectus scale here, ladies and gentlemen.
Taunting Jovi here, and just kind of jawjacking with the crowd as well.
Jawjacking with the crowd, taunting Jovi. He did not come to play games.
Honestly, it looks like he is playing a little bit games. It's almost like he's playing. Sees Jovi as praying. He's playing with him here. And stomping away at Jovi now.
Yep, big stomps in the corner from Jovi, talking mad stuff to Jovi in the corner.
What's he setting up here? Is he setting up for that Meteora? Meteora! And then drop kick in the corner.
Big drop kick in the corner. Almost looked like a Claymore.
Yeah, Claymore in the corner. That's gotta be a big strike. Oh my god. I was actually surprised Jovi got up from that. And he got up again. Yeah. Jovi just pie-facing Pierce. Pierce just striking him down again. And watch, look at this replay.
Watch this Claymore in the corner.
Just right to the side of the head.
That is so phenomenal. talking smack to Joby while he's going to pick. Can he pick this big guy up?
Whoa! He got him up for a big vertical suplex.
Going for the pin.
And that.
And Joby kicks out
right away. But that's the thing about Pierce is he's a lot stronger than you would think. He is able to pick up some of the bigger people in this NWCE. Going for cover again.
And Joby's kicking out.
Kicking out and pie-facing Pierce again.
That's one thing about Sun. Sun is a fighter. He would never give up. And he is showing everybody that he is the resident rock star of the world. Reversal. Now here comes Joby.
Joby going for it. Oh, pop rocks and soda.
He nailed it. And Joby quickly going for the pin.
And Pierce being smart, showing his ring awareness there, grabbing the rope right away and just rolling out to the outside.
Out the ring to catch his rope. But I wouldn't stand there if I was Pierce because you know Joby.
Now, he
get motivated. He will take a risk and go through those ropes.
Yes, he will. And while Pierce does have the experience advantage over Joby, Joby does have a good size advantage and sometimes a strength advantage. Big DDT!
And now Joby going for his famous.
Drop the base.
Drop the base.
There we go. Going for the cover. And Pierce getting the shoulder up. You're not going to get Pierce down that fast. You know, it took James Marshall almost nearly.
Watch this drop the base
fight
again,
even
ladies and gentlemen.
Last
look at that.
Time.
Big drop the base.
Yeah, that's big, big drop the base there.
Now, Sean, is he going for his moonsault?
Oh, big, almost like a crossbody moonsault, Bam Bam style standing. And again, Pierce gets the shoulder up.
And now, Joby. Put him in that chin lock. Got him in that chin lock position.
Yeah, he does, and he's got him right there.
Come on.
Is Mr. Pierce going to pass out, tap out? What is he going to do here? I don't think he's going to do either one.
Because, you know, he has, you know, he's just coming back, and he wants that title back that he held when we first started this company. And a big back suplex!
Yep, a big count out of nowhere. Both men down from that big suplex. That took a lot out of Jonathan. It took out a lot of Sean Joby. Both men are down.
Well, these two men are down. We were just waiting for the ref's counting. I want to remind you folks that we still have to come. Our main event, the Ring of Destruction match between Mr. Brightside, the All Out Champion, and James Marshall for said WCE All Out Championship.
That is true. And that is going to be one hell of a banger match. Because those two have been going at it since the beginning of the season.
That is right. And these two just exchanging blows here.
Back and forth. They are going at it.
Physically,
and now Sean is fired up and he's had enough of Mr. Pearson. Here we go.
What's he doing here? Big running clothesline to kneeling Pierce.
And a two and a quarter.
Two and a quarter there. And Pierce staying in here.
What can Sean Joby do to stop? What is Sean doing? He's getting ready to climb this rope here. He's going to the bottom. Are you going to the second? Yes, he is.
He's going to the second rope. He likes to hit that, drop the base off the second rope sometimes.
Stupid!
Yeah!
Pierce rolls out of the way. I think he gave Pierce a little bit too much time there.
Took his time getting up there. But watch he going for it again. And ladies and gentlemen, and look at it. By an inch, he almost nailed that move.
Yeah, he did.
And now Pierce is stalking him, getting up. Now Pierce is ready.
Big double front drop kick to the side of the head.
That was a good double drop kick. Sean is down. So, and now Pierce.
Pierce planning to do here.
Is he going for the figure four? Yes, he is, ladies and gentlemen. He got it locked in, but.
But he's right. Oh, he got too close to the ropes, but he's keeping it locked in because you got to remember, he got until 5 to break a hole when the
ropes got the rope. And
break.
But if Pierce was smart, he would pull them away from the ropes. He has some.
I don't discount Pierce here. I think that was actually by design, having Joby because of the ropes.
And this is your champion?
And again, taunting the crowd and asking, is this your champion?
Come on, Rockstar!
And just jaw-jacking with Pierce, with Joby as Pierce. Yeah.
And now he's getting... Is he getting ready for his spear?
Yeah, looking for that piercing blow! Piercing blow!
And there it is. But why he did that's not go for the cover? Spear. He got Sean down.
He just said, that's how you do a spear. But Sean, again, showing his ring awareness, and he got the ropes as well.
And now Pierce is so confused, don't know what else to do. He has hit Sean with everything he has gotten. And Sean is still
I'm wrestling for a title, not you.
Jaw jacking to the ref.
He's still jaw jacking to the crowd.
And now Sean is up. And I think he just.
These two just going at it.
They are jaw jacking to each other. And now look at this. Headbutt.
Headbutt. Yeah.
Another headbutt. Another headbutt. Sean landing with that big prone of his.
He just called him out there. What's he gonna do?
Record. Are you seeing that famous record there?
Yes, cover rain.
And that's a good call.
And drops a base as well.
This could be it.
Getting the shoulder up.
He has hit Pierce with everything he has got, and now Pierce. Powered out to the ring because he got hit hard with that purple rain and the drop the bass.
And the other thing I want to point out here is that Joby isn't getting up as fast as he usually does as well here. I think Pierce might have a chance to actually get here, but what is he doing here? I don't know how smart this is. He's going to the outside.
I think Pierce is just fed up because he has hit everything. He's grabbing the belt.
What's he going to do here?
He's grabbing the belt.
He's going to try to the ref.
If he uses that belt, he's going to get disqualified.
Joby catches him. Tell me why!
He hit him with his new finisher. Can it be
it? 1, 2, and Pierce letting himself get blinded and attempt to get the title to cheat here did not work for him as Joby capitalizes, hits Tell Me Why, and gets the 3 count on Mr. Pierce.
That was a hard-hitting match, ladies and gentlemen, and yes.
And I don't...
did not think that completely through. Wasn't expecting Joby to recover. I think he was going to use this belt, try to get himself disqualified. Whatever he's planning on doing with the belt, it did not work.
No, but it didn't. And Joby is once again successfully defending the title.
Tell me why!
In the second reign of the resident rockstar as top of the Interstate Championship Division in WWE.
Tell me why!
Has
it still continues, Joby is still rocking.
But I don't think Pierce is done with Joby yet, and I don't think Joby will be done with him either. But now, folks, Pierce is recovering the ring, and we see the Rockstar, make his way out. I will tell you, it is time now. We're gonna get ready for our main event as Mr. Brightside goes against James Marshall.
We see y'all soon.